Hey, what's up? Great seeing you. This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, and today, this is a very special episode of Dr. Eye Health, where in fact, I'm going to show you a little sneak peek where I got to be interviewed by Dr. Dave from Dr. Dave's 411. If you haven't met Dr. Dave before, he is a practicing board-certified cardiologist with an extreme passion for sharing medical knowledge and preventative medicine. So let's just jump straight into the interview as we share how a simple eye exam can tell you a lot about your heart and your overall health.
Hi, Dr. Alan. Thank you for joining us on call with Dr. Dave, preventative cardiologist from New York. We talk about preventing heart disease. And I bet you're wondering, how the heck did I end up on this channel? I'm an eye doctor. In fact, I am Dr. Eye Health. So welcome to the channel. And I'm really looking forward to speaking with you.
Well, thank you so much for having me on. This is exciting. And there's, as I'm sure you probably know, but there's a lot that goes on with the eyes that's related to the heart. So I'm excited to get into some stuff.
That's great. So why don't we just get to it? So as a practicing cardiologist, when we perform physical exams, we're looking at just about everything. And one of the most obvious areas we look at in general when we speak to people and communicate is their eyes. And of course, they've been called the windows of the soul, but I also think they're windows of general health. Now, if you don't mind, take us from the moment you look at somebody's eyes, and then you can go into the exam further if you wish. Are there any clues in general that you would say to somebody, hey, you know, I'm concerned about X, Y, and Z, and maybe you should consider getting your heart checked?
Absolutely. So right away, when we see a patient in the clinic, of course, you just generally look at your patient's face, you look at them in the eyes, just without even getting close with a slit lamp or a microscope like we use in the clinic, you can already tell some subtle things, especially like yesterday, I had a patient who already had developed some yellowing around their eyelids, which we know is called xanthalasma. So immediately I asked them, hey, when's the last time you went in to see your family doctor before I even got into even doing the exam? And he's like, why is that? I'm like, well, I can see you got some things growing on here. And he's like, oh yeah, I've had those for a few years. And so I told him, yeah, we should get your cholesterol levels checked. And you know, he was only in his early 40s. So that's an early tip off, not super common, but that was just an example. A couple of other things is looking at just the colored part of the eye. I know a lot of people ask me, why am I getting this bluish or yellow ring around the colored part of their eye? We call that arcus senilis. And that, even though after the age of 40, it's somewhat considered normal, it is a sign of elevated cholesterol levels. And some people have a really remarkable level of that. That's just on the front surface of the eye. Really, what tells us more about cardiology, your heart health, and really your whole bodily health is when we examine the inside of the eye and we're able to look at the retina in the back, because the back of the eye is just pure network of blood vessels. In fact, the retina has a dual blood supply. It's got blood vessels on the inner side of the retina, and then it's got blood vessels in the back of the retina. But it, like you yourself, you guys do echocardiograms, you do angiographies, you guys do carotid ultrasounds, and you kind of look at the blood vessels through these separate mediums. In eye care, we look directly into the eye and you can see the blood vessels in action. Yeah. So if you can see their blood vessels getting damaged from something like diabetes, from high blood pressure, from cholesterol plaques getting stuck in the arteries, I mean, we have a direct line to view what's going on and what else could be going on inside the body. So a lot of times, you know, I'll see a blood vessel changes that are indication of high blood pressure. So we'll check blood pressure there in the office. And sure enough, it'll be like 180 over like 100. And so immediately we're like, okay, we need to get you referred on over to the hospital across the street. So that's just a couple of examples. But it's remarkable how often we'll catch, it's not just glasses and contacts. So we're checking on basically everything in the body.
And so what strikes me about your answer and what is so incredibly important, and it's so important for people to go for regular eye exams, is everything you mentioned, cholesterol, diabetes, high blood pressure, all part of silent killers. right? Mm-hmm. They don't come up to the person and say, hey, here I am, diabetes, your sugar is high, right? Or, hey, your blood pressure has been running a little bit higher than it should be. Or, you know, you have high cholesterol, here I am. These are things that astute clinicians such as yourself will pick up. So again, I'm a preventative cardiologist, so I love to hear this stuff. This is the stuff that it gives us an opportunity to intervene before the stroke, before the heart attack, before the limb loss, before the kidney disease. So those are such great points and, you know, definitely need to be incorporated. I'll say one more thing. The sign of a good clinician is not just focusing on their world alone, but opening up, no pun intended, their eyes to what else is going on. So I really appreciate those comments. That was excellent.
So what a huge honor it was to be interviewed by Dr. Dave himself and to be featured on his channel. If you want to learn additional information from Dr. Dave, go ahead and check out all of his different social channels between his Facebook page, his YouTube channel, all those different things. I'll put links to those all in the description below. But first, let me know and drop a comment below this video. Anything cool about the eyes and heart health or bodily health that you know about, and what would you like to discuss with Dr. Dave himself here on this channel? We're gonna plan to have him back on and discuss cool things. What kind of video, what kind of topics and things like that would you like to learn from Dr. Dave? Otherwise, thanks so much for watching. Love you guys. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.